Thank you. That was lovely.
Well, that's certainly a matter of opinion.
Well, hopefully we'll have you back next time.
Yeah, or maybe not. Who was that anyway?
What do you mean?
Who was that performing just then?
That was me.
Oh, but you were talking as if...
Yeah, that's what I do. That's my shtick. I pretend I'm more than one person talking to myself, and I have all these elaborate characters and whatnot.
So, okay, who are you then? You the composer of what we just heard?
I'm Gwitty, and this is my podcast.
Oh, okay.
Who are you?
Oh, well, I'm Edward.
Well, I know you're Edward.
Well, I know. We're kind of having this conversation for the sake of the others.
Oh, right. Of course.
So, what do you think, BT?
Oh, you know, I think it was a sincere expression. It was, it seemed to come from a place of, you know, grooviness, and, you know, I'm all for that.
Well, thank you. At least I have one vote. Edward, what exactly was your problem with it?
Well, if you're a silent client, then why are you talking?
Well, I think that strictly speaking, if someone is a silent client, there are cases in which they would identify themselves as such, but not openly speak, you know.
Okay, I guess. But, I mean, it seems like you just sort of threw the words together because they sort of rhyme. Silent client? Ent? I guess?
Yes, it's a masculine rhyme. It's a serious rhyme. Not one of those silly feminine rhymes like oopsie doopsie, opsie daisy, flopsie mopsie, cottontail, and all that bullshit.
Oh, right, I see. Yeah, I do vaguely remember that as well.
What about you, Pymander?
Oh, the song, yeah, I thought it was groovy, but honestly, I'm just looking forward to when you guys are done with this recording so we can listen to some Daka Braka and get back to some cleaning.
Is that you, Pymander?
Yeah? What of it?
Well, you usually speak with this, like, many voices at once. I am all of us.
Yeah, but I figured fuck that. You know, I just want to be myself, you know?
Yes, I see.
So anyone else? Sonnet 1, what do you think?
A comfortable mocha hides tersely from within a mist.
Oh, that's very interesting, Sonnet 1. Would you care to elaborate on that, or maybe explain a little bit what you mean by that?
Why are you even trying?
Oh, just, you know, as a device, just to get him talking.
A friendly lady falls obscenely all over the first.
Okay, so the first what?
When a foot paints a stranger, the most devastating finger kills harmoniously through a gripe.
Oh, that actually kind of made sense. What did you get out of that, BT?
Well, when a foot paints a stranger, so when with the limitations of the sensory, you know, the ephemeral, you know, stuff that we would attribute to the foot, the Malkuth, the tree, and the body, when it paints a stranger, it can only do so through previous experience and stereotypes, rather than actually meeting the stranger. And when it does that, the most devastating finger kills harmoniously through a gripe. So you bring in something that has nothing to do with that situation, and it kills any possibility for the, you know, what might have been in that interaction.
Well, holy shit, I think we need to get Sonnet 1 together with Fratter BT more often. Yeah, oh my god, I never would have seen that. Yeah, do another one. Sonnet 1, what do you think about what Fratter BT just said?
Joyously, the saints choke strangely on the flu. A nameless armchair believes truly outside of all of you.
Okay, BT, what do you get from that one?
The saints, honestly, I get very little, but if I really squint and kind of do this, you know, then I would say that, you know, the saints, for whatever that means, you know, some kind of enlightened being, they choke strangely on the flu, but joyously, so they're happy that they're choking to death, or maybe not to death, and then the nameless armchair believes truly outside of all of you. That just seems kind of self-explanatory now, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, I suppose it does. That's a little creepy.
Well, you know, they wouldn't be listening if we weren't talking. Creepy is as creepy does.
Oh, that was kind of Forrest Gumpy.
A little bit. Who's talking now? Does it really matter?
Signoritoth, can you control him?
Yes, no problem.
No, really, it doesn't matter who's talking.
No, I'm inclined to agree. I think my balls should do the talking.
Is that Schlenschenheimer? Get him out of here. Get him.
Hey, you said you would speak respectfully to me.
Please get him out of here. Thank you all for tuning in. Good yesterday.
Let's get ridiculous! Yeah. Yeah. Woo! Let's get ridiculous!